Today we're going to talk about ontology and epistemology. Ontology goes to what exists. For us, only the natural world is in our ontology. I'll get back to that in a minute. Epistemology is how do we decide what's true about what exists. And morals, we've spoken about in a previous clip, and it won't be part of this one. Here again, ontology, what is true, what is real, what is the nature of reality. Epistemology is different methods of gaining knowledge about that reality. It's like ontology tells us this cave exists, and then epistemology is like the flashlight we use to go explore the cave and gain knowledge about it. Now, in our ontology, we accept the natural world, and for reasons I discussed in a previous video, we don't accept the supernatural because we can't know something is beyond nature. Even if a godlike being appeared to me, how can I know it's truly a god? Maybe it's a hologram created by aliens in a spaceship or something. I mean, unlikely, but the point is we can't know that something is beyond nature. And in the ontology of religions, typically, supernatural beings are accepted as existing, gods, angels, demons, whatever. Supernatural places, heaven and hell. Now, in the scientific epistemological method, also called the scientific method, here's a simplification of it. And the important thing is testing. In science, we test if something is true. And if it isn't, we reject it, no matter who said it. Even if Newton said it, even if Einstein said it, if they're proven wrong, they're wrong. So, for instance, at one time, actually in the late 1800s, this was part of physics textbooks. There was a belief that the luminous aether existed. Michelson-Morley showed it did not exist. That was a big problem. Einstein explained what was going on, theory of relativity, and the theory of relativity is used for GPS satellites. We did not know the theory of relativity. Those satellites would not give us the correct results. There's a relativistic effect on GPS clocks. They're that sensitive. So the epistemological method of science is like a house built on a rock. Now if we go to the epistemological method of religion, it's choose a scripture. First problem, which scripture? Quran? The Book of Mormon? The Bible? How do you choose? Most people just accept what they were born into. But suppose you weren't born into a religion, you'd have to pick one of those books as your scripture. And once you pick it, you have faith. Faith that you've picked the right book and that the book is true. Well, the epistemological method of religion, for Protestantism, it's often scripture alone, sola scriptura. Now, the Catholic Church accepts scripture, tradition, and the teaching authority of the popes and the cardinals and the bishops. So we'll concentrate on the simpler choice, sola scriptura, the Bible alone. Now, if you accept the Bible, if you really accept the Bible, you should believe, I think, that Adam and Eve were literal people. Right? And you should believe that the earth is, well, now they say 6,000 years, maybe 10,000 years, but the point is not 4 billion years. And there are young earth creationists who believe or argue that the earth is 10,000 years old, or some number, but let's say about 10,000. A lot of Bible-believing Christians just don't believe in evolution. A few of the more liberal ones say, okay, evolution exists, but it was directed by God. So a lot of Christians see an opposition between evolution and the Bible. The Tower of Babel, is that how languages developed? We know that languages didn't develop in one place, but that's what the story says. There are flat earthers, and I don't know if any of them actually get their inspiration from the Bible. Maybe they do, because there is a description in the Bible of a flat earth, and that was the view of the ancient Hebrews I've read. So, the epistemological method of religion is like a house built on sand. You have to decide which scripture. You have to decide how to interpret the scripture. It's not a secure foundation. Now, of course, you might say, well, scientists are wrong sometime and religious people were wrong. Yes. But scientists don't claim to be anything more than human beings. They're using natural reason. They're trying to find out about the world. They're doing experiments. They're theorizing. And sometimes they're wrong. But religious people, if you have a book written by God, if you have a book like that, I don't think you should persecute women as being witches for 2, 3, 4 centuries and then decide, well, they really aren't. I don't think you should decide that that book is so poorly written that you can think for centuries it supports slavery and then decide, well, maybe it doesn't. So I think that the epistemological method of religion is faulty, and if it's faulty, it's kind of the blind leading the blind. Thank you. I'm preaching a sermon to show it ain't